All right, pretty sure we're live now. Making sure everything's working. Hold Yeah, it looks like we're definitely live. I already sent out the ping beforehand because I'm learning. And yeah, okay, well, let's just hope that we don't lag out like last time. And I don't know why I'm subjecting myself to more top tier USA grinding, but I mean I just wanna grind out the tree as fast as I can so I don't have to deal with this anymore. But I'm trying. But I don't know. At this rate, I mean it's gonna take forever and I'm really quite tired of grinding out this BR. It's like this particular BR that I don't like so much. This particular BR, I mean it's I don't know, I mean like before like 9.3 and everything it was like okay. But like the penetration should not be the same at like 9.3 as it is at like 10.7. So definitely a bit of an issue. Why it's so difficult at this VR. But like, I'm just about to get to the tanks that don't suck so much, so yeah, hold on a little bit longer. Also, have a reaction to the Firebird Trailer or Warthunder, something like that. Very interesting. Pretty sure saw that Germany was willing to get another vehicle for ground, so that's kind of cool, but I was like World War II, of course. And then Russia's getting in World War II. I think it was KV-7 or 13, if I remember right. So I'll see if I can grind it out. Oh my goodness. A consistent factor that I lose my horizontal every single time. Also, my vertical, so that's nice. Well, nice. That's great. I lost like my one tank that does pretty good sometimes. And I gotta play with this. I mean, hey, gets higher penetration, that's for sure. But it's so slow. I don't know what they were thinking when they decided to just put a heavier turret on the M16 chassis without giving it a better engine. So kind of struggling with that. Also find it silly how it gets the penetration of the 120 barrel, because I mean it gets a 120 barrel but it's a lower BR than the 105 millimeter barrel Abrams. Kind of silly. Well, I try to do good, so try to focus a little bit. Give you know entertainment, so it's a balance. I gotta get used to that, I suppose. Oh man. Dude, come on. Oh my, my vertical's out. If it's not my horizontal, it's my vertical. This is ridiculous. Wow, that's just wonderful, man. Why are they over? Attention to the map. Oh, I'm actually free back now. obviously Ardent is just a bad map all around most of the time. Especially the east side, from what I know, it's like no cover. I haven't gotten to do any good with the FPT-70 right now, because I mean, it's a 9.3, it gets no penetration pretty much. Even for the PR that's had, it gets low penetration. Absolutely ridiculous. My entire round just get consumed by a single like little bit of ERA there. Just how good the round is, really. Just really selling it off now. Wow. Yeah, honestly, really good match so far, I think. Man, I keep doing that. Since it's Saints, I just keep, like, dragging it. It's like you grab, like, right there, and then, I don't know, I keep doing that. It's kind of annoying, to be honest. Again, I'm probably only gonna be streaming around the same amount of length of time as the last time. So probably, like, around an hour or so. Because I do have things to do before going to bed, so. Just gonna... You know, I try and make some progress, like a good amount of progress, and we're in night battle, okay? Night battles aren't the worst, I suppose. Honestly, I just don't really. Like, right now, the NPD is good, but I feel like a lot of the time when it gets, like, brighter randomly. It just is really bad, especially on like desert or snow maps. Like, when it gets brighter, I don't even need it because it's just so bright. Kind of ridiculous. Like, right now, I mean, it's alright. But it gets really bad. Alright, still done off of that. Also, still ridiculous camo using an urban plant. I have no clue why they label it as an urban slash desert camo. I don't really get how this is supposed to be urban anyway. Also, just keep watching out to see if my stream is lagging or not. I'm still kind of scared about that. Hoping that doesn't happen. Well, that's what I was causing it last time for, like, definite. I'm pretty sure it was just either Twitch or my internet. But, I mean, I have pretty good internet most of the time. I wasn't lagging on my end when that was all happening last stream. Okay. Oh, okay. My mind. Just a little bit. Tank out there. Is not watching, okay. Well, I know I'm in good hands then, huh? Up here, and then it's just like some guys in the edge of the map waiting. kind of sad, but also really annoying. Yep, there he is. Man, I really hate Leopard 2s. Oh, did not see you. Oh my, you're kidding. Oh. Biggest problem about the Abrams right there is the same orbit weak spot that can be penetrated by like anything at all. Yeah, I don't got NVD for this thing, so. But hey, it's alright. I mean, like, why do you need NVD in a night battle? It's so bright out. Don't even need to worry about it, really. It's not like the slowest tank ever, but it's, I mean, compared to everything else that has VR, it's really slow. Like, honestly, I don't know why they didn't just, like, do what they did, or the Germans did with the M48s that they got, where they put better engines in them and everything, and they have a whole bunch faster, while also being, like, the same weight. Or like the M48 Super that gets like a solid horsepower engine. Like, I don't know why they couldn't just do that. I mean, it fits in the same engine bay and everything. And it's so much faster. Okay, we're still doing good. No lag, dream thus far. Specifically for armor, I mean, honestly, I feel like the 120S is just about the same as armor for the M1 Abrams, because they both get like no armor at all. Although the 120S does get the normal turret armor for the Abrams, but the early M1 Abrams, man, it gets like over a little over 300 millimeters of armor. It's really unfortunate. But a lot of time you'll just get shot like right through the front of the turret. But it doesn't happen on this one, but the hull has absolutely no armor, so it's just like there's no good options. Kind of a problem with it, the, I don't know, it's part of the US tree, to be honest. You just get okay tanks. Sad to be honest, that guy was waiting there the entire drive back just for somebody to pop out. I'm surprised they didn't see me, because he definitely had NVD. I mean, it's a premium thing, so definitely has it unlocked. Literally, like, I mean, there's nobody watching, let's be honest here. But, you know, anybody watching the VOD, maybe, or anybody watching it back on Twitch, I do have a Discord server, YouTube channel, X account, you know, Twitter, and all those in the bio, like you can see on the right side of my screen. I let you guys know. Really appreciate any support at all. For me, I'll be up there. I looked at that, I had a feeling. I thought the tank may have been alive, but it was not sore at all. Kind of looked like it was dead just because of how mundane the camo was. Yeah, also your tank get no NVD either, because, well, I mean, it doesn't have thermal, and it's 9.3, so I just don't equip the NVD. Which is a waste of money most of the time. Yeah, I'm really planning to use the preset after I get tanks. but it's not, I mean, it's not the worst map that you can get. There are some horrendous maps. Hello. Ooh. You get commander control? I don't think it does. Yeah, I'm not even controlling for that, to be honest. Honestly, I'm surprised you didn't shoot me. I saw that humans definitely got to shoot me today. But I just ended up reacting faster, I guess, than you could aim. What? Okay, there you go. Yeah, it's over for you. Alright, well, that went pretty good. My favorite, I wasn't sure if I was going to be able to win that one, considering playing the MBT 70 at 10.7 right now. Hell man, it just BR a lot of plane tanks I get pretty weird sounding engines, to be honest. I just can't tell sometimes. I mean, to be honest, like, if I keep going for a little while, I mean, not even like that long, I'll probably get that 1128 by the time I'm done with the stream, or, you know, before I'm done with the stream. So I think that's when I'll end the stream, is when I get the M1128. So, I mean, depending on how we do, that could be a long time, or, like, really, like, any point now, like, right around the corner. Honestly, kind of excited to get it, because it's like, I mean, it's a pretty good vehicle, to be honest, other than the EFS grind that we're gonna have to go through at the start, which I'm sure I'll get plenty of, like, great content out of that. I do upload these, well, I sometimes, depending on the clips, will make shorts out of them on YouTube. And, I mean, to say the least, EFS is comical with how bad it does, so I feel like I will get some good clips out of that. Also, interesting thing in the trailer, new Warfighter trailer, looks like they're possibly updating lighting in in the game or something like that. Kind of a graphical update. So I'm pretty hyped for that. I mean, to be honest, that's like why I hyped up for the most number of tanks being had. Because, I mean, it's like basically the one thing that I almost like more than when they add tanks is they make the game look better, more immersive and everything. Honestly, what I probably care about more than that is sounds. Like, you know, gunfire sounds and engines and all that. I care about that quite a lot too. Stop saying to be honest. It's like a tick or something at this point. Like, holy cow. Yeah, seeing. I mean, to be honest. The one thing I like about the even more than the Leopard 2 is the turn time, definitely. Turn time's really nice. Turn on like a dime. Oh, I am blind. I mean, obviously turn on dime, but very fast turn and very fast reload. It's very nice. Okay, well, you won't be able to hear my engine now. But I'd still prefer to have one. Sounds like they're gonna pop out like right here. So bad now. Oh, he's blind. Blind as a bat. Well, this is kind of a unfortunate situation. Look, another coming down here. Okay. Kind of afraid of getting like sandwiched in. Oh my, I did not mean to press that. It's unfortunate. Yeah, I think you know what I'm here. Like, yeah, just like, come on, just like, shoot it. What you gotta do now? Gotta drive around the corner? Okay, just leave it. I don't think he's coming close. Yeah, he's just going, okay. Weird. Okay, going around the block, he's just gonna try to like burn me out, I feel like. But I have my track now, so it doesn't matter at all. Generally, a pretty good plan. I'm just gonna like back out, I think. What the HP is, to be, so is, though. I'll be honest. I mean, honestly, like, I know nothing really about machine guns and tanks. Probably why I know the least amount of tanks, or about tanks, excuse me. But, it's kind of probably one of the more parts, I feel like. And it's just, like, small cannon, so it's a big one. You don't really pay attention to it as much. Stream's not crashing. Okay, the stream is not in fact crashing. That's nice. Still scared about that from yesterday. Just crashing over and over again. Let's see, I mean, imagine we got a pretty good amount. Oh my goodness, yeah. Just about as much as the last game. So, like, if we keep doing this, that's like about two more games. Until we get it, hopefully. Because I'm ending stream, definitely, once I get that 1128. Because I mean, I don't have much time to stream, to be honest. So I'm just gonna try to get the M1128, and then next stream we can play around with that and see how terrible that's going to be to play, unless I end up playing with Rob. Rob's Reef, you know, guy I play with, friend. YouTube channels. Yeah, I have a YouTube channel linked on my YouTube and Discord. If you want to check him out, he's a pretty cool guy. And another night battle, okay. Not really complaining. Slowly working towards those night battle rewards. Also, I do upload all the VODs from my streams onto my YouTube channel. I'll watch those back. Or you can just watch them on Twitch, but eventually they will get deleted. Try to custom matches or something like that. I'm not sure. getting this transmission in track. I can't even tell where he's looking, to be honest. Oh, he's definitely not directly looking at me. Never mind, not yet. Oh, okay. I mean, I'll take a assist. Get him out of my hair. Hello? Oh my, that guy is hit me with like the craziest whip shot ever. I saw I had him there, to be honest. I completely had him, but no. Man, I really wish I could get NVD for 120S. Pretty sure, unless I don't remember right, the 120S gets sent free for all things. It's kinda awesome. The Praetor uses like one of the newest Apex turrets that they have. Huge Gen 3s. Generally, I feel like this vehicle wouldn't be so bad if it just had an engine that wasn't, you know, the same one being used for, I mean, probably for like 50 years ago. Thanks, bro. I didn't want those guys anyway. Holy crap. That's so annoying. I couldn't even see him. Just somewhere out there. I'd like to go, but like, I don't know where he is. On the front of the 2S38, I was just gonna shoot that, but then before I know it, like a T80 or something, I'm pretty sure the T80 just like flies around the corner. Oh man, that's not the one, but about to get killed. I don't even know what that was. I don't see people doing that too often, but if I do, it's usually Russian, to be honest. It's just kind of how it goes. Oh, okay. Well, it's ridiculous how much armor those turrets get. And everything apparently gets on them. Holy cow. I wanna like penetrate their armor. That's why I wanna play Russia after I'm done with the US. Is Russia or Israel? I'm not sure what I'm gonna go for. Probably Russia though. Probably like Russia. Certainly a guy like back there. I just can't do anything about it. It's really annoying. I dodged it. Okay, I'm just not allowed to get killed, apparently. Like, what are you talking about? How did I not get that kill? Shot the T-72 twice in the side. I mean, admittedly, one of them was pretty bad. But, like, the second one, I mean, that was, like, right under the turret. Like, how did I not kill him? So, yeah, definitely not getting it within two games, apparently. It's not allowed. Wow. Yeah, Russian tanks, I mean, it's so impossible to do anything to them, really. Kinda why I want to play Russian trees, just because, I mean, they get some crazy tanks. I just want to know what it's like to not die every time you get hit. Because America really has a problem with that. And another night battle. Okay, Gaijin. Wish I had firmware for the 120S or something right now. So use to turn on thermals as soon as I spawn, but I don't need to in my battles. See, like right now in this type of lighting, like you don't even need it. Literally, it's just like, I mean, it's like the shadows are dark, but everywhere else is light. That really doesn't matter. And if you use NVD, it's just like you're looking into the sun, so. Honestly, with night battles, where it's just, you know, like, basically pitch black. That'd be nice. Pretty sure that's how it used to be. I didn't ever get to play them, though. Of how they used to be. They were, like, updated to how they are now, just before. It's not what I wanted to do. Like just before I got to high tier. Nobody's coming down here. I didn't even notice that we had like only, what is this? 8 people on each team. So no wonder I'm not seeing anybody. Very far and few people in, although I think I hear the light. Nah, I'm just losing it. That's a joke. No way. That's so annoying. Literally shoot like under the tank and it just gets me nothing. Like, of course. Why would I have the horizontal drive after I get stunned? That's what I'm talking about. Every time you get stunned to Abrams, you lose either the horizontal or vertical drive. It is without, like, I mean, it's a constant thing. It's just a factor of life. I mean, you can't control it. It's just how it is. Like, it's actually so dumb. What is going on around here? Why are we repairing it? Are they literally right up here? Because I'm gonna be a little mad. That's how this is already going. Another part of why I like Russia tanks. stay right there. Stay right there. Let's go. Teamwork makes a dream work. A little cheesy, I guess you'd say. Yeah, I'd like to start getting more kills maybe, so I could do a little bit better. Or get more RP for the M1128 here, but we'll see. Hey. Dude, what? You're kidding. Oh, man. Don't do that. Oh, there goes my horizontal again. See, I should have seen him in the back of my head. Didn't know he was there. Can't hear anything because of how much chaos is constantly happening, too. I'm just gonna make sure the stream is still working. Yeah, we're good. Cannot trust it. Well, I mean, at least we got like a couple of good games in so far. Otherwise, it's just like really unfortunate games. A lot of night battles too, which is not making things easy because I don't have a thermal or SPD on a lot of my tanks. Is a 2S38 dead or are we just kinda like, I really hate when that happens, it's so annoying. Some tank is like left alone on your teammates and nobody on your team cares, which lets them just like I don't know, just like sit in between the building or something, just waiting. Happens so often too. Even top heroes usually were people that know actually how to play the game go. Or are around. I'm not really thinking I'm gonna get many kills here. Because I'm not seeing a lot of people under the guys up on B. Get a flank on him maybe, unless the other side is still up. Kind of annoying because there's like absolutely like nobody around right now. So it's kind of hard to find the. I mean, it's kind of like, it's kind of a jump scare when people show up. Do not expect at all. How many people you aren't seeing. Hello? Bro, why? Is it just Russian players or like. I feel like I see Russian players all the time do that type of stuff. Where instead of like turning their tankers on and turn into a direction faster, they just look slowly with their turret over to where they're trying to think the enemy's coming. Yeah, I see that all the time. I don't know. I don't understand why I do it so often, but I always see Russian players doing that. Like, they forget that even they can die if they, you know, don't, like, put their armor frontally. Although, I've shot plenty of tanks, or Russian tanks on the side, and done absolutely nothing. So, you know, doesn't really matter, I guess, where they put their armor. NVD, if I had thermal blasting, then I could turn them on, but nope. Probably look around the corner of the camera, but that'd be smart. I don't know how smart it is. I mean, I guess I'm doing a little bit better now. Probably still not gonna get like 7,000 RP or anything like before. Yeah, it'll work. Alright. Alright, let's see what we got. That's a lot more than I saw. Oh, I think I just got a tier in the MBT-70 here. That's why move down so much. Yeah. Okay, that's really awesome, actually. That's nice. So, I mean, if we do not get to 1128 next game, then it is a skill issue. Or it's just really unlucky. I mean, it's really unlikely that I don't get it next game. Honestly, North Holland's a pretty good map. I mean, I think it's been a little bit since they added it, but I don't know. Still feels like a new map to me. How most maps go at this point in my mind. Most of the new ones all feel pretty new to me, unless they're like reskins. Although I don't know. Service 13. See, I want online. It's surprisingly common. Yeah, I think. Like, I don't personally really have much of a problem with them making snow variations of maps, but I don't. I really have a problem with is when they advertise that as entirely new. Like, oh, look at the new map we're adding, and it's just like the same map with snow all over. It's just, I mean, they shouldn't advertise it as like a big new map in that update. They just say, hey, we're adding the snow variation, the winter variation of this map. Instead of just, you know, hyping up to be a completely different map while it's not. Right there. I hate blizzard so much, man. Actually, the most annoying thing ever. Genuinely so annoying. When they smother their tank and blizzards cannot even like see anything. So you know what tank you're fighting. There's just so many blizzards you can't even tell or see a blue spot or anything. Like a tank to me. That guy's right here. Are you kidding me? Yeah, just don't move. Oh, okay. Hold on. Just wait a little bit longer. Yeah, I'm not here. Don't worry about it. Okay. Thanks for waiting, man. Okay, now I'm gonna try to get some of the crew. That's not crew. Nothing, really. Oh, you angry at me? I mean, I don't blame you. Okay, no fire. Fire? No fire. Okay. Okay. Oh, okay. Ammunition explode? Okay, I got a fuel tank, but no, I don't want to fly. Still working, that's cool.
The enemy has most of the strategic zones.
I'm not waiting any longer. I can't. to nothing, to be honest. Oh. Yeah, they can pull out there, thanks. I'm gonna try and hit some key point now. I like defending sometimes, but most of the time I prefer to go capping points. You get a lot of RP. SL. I mean, it's not like I need SL, to be honest, but... I mean... I've been hovering around like 17 to 18 million a whole bunch, so I wouldn't mind getting more. I think every time I get nearly or over 18 million, I get a tank that's like at least 1 million SL. So I just kind of feel like I'm going north lately, the SL game. Sudden you have like 5 artillery starting to come into your location. Okay, thought I could react in time. Maybe I'm hearing something. Okay, there's a guy right back here. I mean, you could just pull out here, I don't really mind. Hit the brakes any harder than I did. Kinda unlucky. It's kinda annoying how Russian players do that. It's like you hear no end of town or anything, and I mean, like they're getting ready, and it's like waiting there behind the corner. I mean, they could have been waiting there for like 10 minutes, I'm not even sure. Sometimes it kinda feels like that, considering that you hear nothing at all, and they're just waiting right around that corner. That you've been sitting at for a little bit. No end sound or anything. They've just been there. Like, idly waiting while you just do your thing. Very interesting Russian player try. I see a whole bunch. Which honestly, it's kind of almost sometimes it feels like Russian players are just not very, like, good at the game. But just because they're using tanks that are invincible to like most tanks at their VRs, they just get so many easy kills. That's how it feels a lot of time. Like there are good Russian players, but it's feeling like the majority are just people that boots off the fact that they're indestructible most of the time. Other than like the 2 week mods, they're like pixels. Lucky that I even got the APFSDS round for it, to be honest, because that was a grind. EFS stock grind is abysmal. Hello? Can't believe I didn't see him until now. It's kind of embarrassing. We're all blind. No! Please, spare me, man. Spare me. Okay, now you can just fly around the corner. Oh, hello. That ain't 238. Oh my goodness. Who could have seen this coming? Another 238 player? That's unbelievable. It's like it's a good like premium tank or something. I don't know. It kind of feels like that. Maybe. Thank you. Like, I genuinely see so many people that use the 2S38. I mean, it's just, I mean, so, I don't know, it kind of feels weird to me how every, like, major, like, ER, like, bracket always gets some kind of weird overpowered Russian thing. Like, every single time. Like, for, like, the 9.0 range, you get the optic 279. I mean, that thing's so annoying. Like, completely indestructible to tanks at, like, even higher BRs than it, to be honest, and it just, like, for some reason, still at 9.3, and genuinely way higher. God, annihilate you? I really gotta, I mean, you just gotta love autocannons. So one good thing, I think, basically, like, the one part I like about the MET-70 is that they always get 30mm autocannon, at least the one that gets the, like, actual, like, good one, not like the XML blade. But it gets, like, a normal looking gun. Like, this, Fraser 30mm one. Good FPAA and Tinker of light tanks, and just, like, anything like that. Doing so bad to me, guys. I mean, I guess America isn't absolutely the worst. Hello. Pretty sure it's just some helicopter trying to shoot me from... Yeah, it's kind of out there. Can't really do anything about it. I find it so dumb how air vehicles are, like, the best vehicles in the ground game mode. So you, like, as a tank, you cannot do anything about a plane or a helicopter shooting you from, like, 10 kilometers out. And that's a drone. Okay. Same guy. Earlier, too. Like, you just can't do anything about it. Like, what are you supposed to do about some guy shooting you from, like, I mean, literally, like, 5-6 kilometers away in a tank? Like, you can't do anything, really. Also, coming up to the hour mark here. Which is, I mean, just about on time, honestly, to what I was on the stream anyway. Get a 2 or M102 lead. That's nice. It's working out. I don't think I'm gonna get any capture bonus, I'm gonna be honest, guys. I don't think I got the time. Maybe I'll be able to shoot somebody over here? Nah. That's unfortunate. There's a guy coming up this way. Too late though. 7 kills though, I mean, it's not the worst. It's honestly, like, my average for, like, any German BR, but, you know. For America, that's pretty good. MBT-70 got camo. Okay, well, there is M1128. It's like, yeah, it's so awesome every time you get a tank. And then, you're so excited and everything. And then, I mean, it's a lot of money. But, I mean, it just doesn't really matter, right? I mean, it's still, like, exciting and everything. And then, yeah, then you look into the research tab. And then you're like, wait a second. Not again. And he kind of grind out from EFS all the way to a dart again. Although, I mean, at least it's not as bad as, like, early dart tanks, because then you don't even get darts in, like, anywhere around the first two ranks for modifications. But, like, it's still so bad. It's just, like, all of a sudden you go from being really excited about getting the tank and everything to, oh, man, I got... grind like 20 games where I get to do absolutely terrible. just to get a dart. I mean, it's, to be honest, it's not that good. American darts aren't even like that amazing. Although, that one's pretty good. You just need to grind all the way down to the bottom. So, yeah, it's really nothing at all. And thermals in rank one. I mean, whoever decided for this modification setup is awesome. I really, really love them. They're a great person. giving like all of the good stuff at rank one here. Although, even though if you get the dart in rank one, you still have to get parts first, because that's probably even gonna be worse than having only EFS. But hey, there you go. M1128, and I also got camo for this guy. And like I do with all my camo, just shrink them down. I think they just look better that way. I mean, most of the time they look better that way. And I feel like they, excuse me, I feel like they just look better in general. And did my stream just go out? My stream is struggling, to say the least. But hey, I mean, I was about to end stream anyway, so it's whatever, really. Okay, now my stream's gone again. It cut out earlier, I guess. That's kind of annoying. Did not notice that happened. But yep. That'll probably be it for the stream then. Next stream, probably still grinding out more US top tier. And stream's lagging again. Wonderful. Really gotta, just gotta love it, you know? And yeah, I'm just gonna end stream now. See you probably tomorrow, maybe.